So football Friday night for your Saturday morning. I'm Dave Griffiths. 6A number 1, 9-0 Brownsburg facing 8-1 number 3 Ben Davis. Max Prep says those West Side rivals made up the third best matchup in the entire United States last night. Better suited for a state title game, but hey, until we get seeding in the playoffs, it's a sectional semifinal here in Indiana. Brownsburg locked in control. Fourth quarter, Garrett Sherrill breaks loose for a 45-yard touchdown, made it 25-7. Get prepared for next week, right? Well, hold on, the Giants aren't done. Thomas Gotkowski for Ben Davis makes the broken play, a touchdown. It's 25-14. Brownsburg now with the ball, passing and picked off. Mark Zachary takes it back for the pick six. It's 25-20 all of a sudden. The Giants get the ball back again, still down by five. Gotkowski again scrambling and again finding the end zone to take a 28-25 Ben Davis lead. Brownsburg would get one more chance on the final possession, looking for the prayer at the buzzer, but it falls incomplete. Ben Davis wins 28-25. Head coach Eric Moore telling the reigning 6A state champ Center Grove a win is their mission against Franklin Central. The CG defense stepping up first. Brody Boswell picking off Nevin Tuttero on the third and long. And the Trojans are going to get great field position for their offense. The offense would take advantage. Tyler Cherry back to pass, finds his favorite target. Noah Coy for the 11-yard touchdown. Trojans lead 7-0. Next time CG touches the ball, more magic as Cherry going deep for Brevin Holabar, hauling in the 65-yard strike, a 13-0 advantage then. CG's defense would be swarming all day. Owen Bright ends up with the FC ball carrier. 40-14, Center Grove wins. If you send your rivals home for the winter, there's no better feeling. Lawrence North taking on Lawrence Central. The Bears here with the ball. Bryson Luter back to pass, finds DeMarcus Cole. Big catch for the first down. LC lost to LN earlier this year, so looking for some sweet revenge last night. Luter dropping back, but this time taking down Carter McKinstry. Blows up the play in the backfield for the sack. Now LN on offense. Montez Jones looking for his favorite target. Davion Chandler, heck of a catch for a former Shelbourne Nee-Center play of the game winner this year, and a touchdown for LN. In the second half, LN's Jones, this time doing damage with his legs. The long touchdown run on the QB keeper, 38-16, Wildcats winners. Fans hoping to see two big offenses at Brebeuf last night, the Lebanon Tigers visiting the Braves. Brebeuf with the ball tied at 21. The ball is passed, tipped, and Caden Lark gets the interception for Lebanon, taking it back all the way inside the 5-yard line. He's tackled shy of the end zone, but Brebeuf actually kept them out of the end zone on the play, a turnover on down. So the Braves take it back. Long ball this time connects. Javon Brooks, the great catch in traffic to keep the drive going. CJ Harris doing the rest of it on the ground, shedding a few tacklers into the end zone for the touchdown, made it 28-21 Brebeuf at that point. Trying to add to it before halftime. This ball picked off by Lark again, his second interception of the first half, but Brebeuf wins 70-49. Out of all the high school football our cameras caught last night, two plays stand out as the best of the best. Now your vote will determine which of them is the winner of the Shelbourne Nee-Center play of the game. Nominee number one, we go to Ben Davis in Brownsburg. You just saw it. Mark Zachary getting the pick six to help the Giants come back on previously undefeated Brownsburg for the 28-25 win. Heck of a play for Zachary, one of the best players in the state. Nominee number two, Zionsville, Noblesville. Eugene Hilton Jr. making his presence felt early. Eli Schulwalter put one up for the star receiver, and he comes down with it in the end zone for the touchdown. Vote for your favorite at Fox59.com.